18-wheeler turnover in my front yard with waste.
Yes, sir.
And by them having to move the truck and get to cut the driver out, and all that waste and stuff was right there in my front yard. Now, the thing about it is I got incarcerated that day as well.
Mm-hmm.
And I never did go up there and talk to them about the situation. And I've been sitting here thinking about it, and I said, I'm going to give y'all a call and see what that, mm-hmm. is there anything that I can do about it? They didn't even fix my driveway. They moved my property line because I had to use a great big old John Deere tractor with a mm-hmm. scoop on it to clear the rubbish back to put it back in the truck or whatever they did, another truck. But they've knocked down my property line, and it's not in the right position, and I'm not financially able to get there. That land.
I'll start on this one, Vic. So, sir, I think you may have, depending on whether or not it was the truck driver's fault that he turned over in your yard, typically you may have a claim against that trucking insurance company for the property damage you incurred. Short of that, you possibly have a claim through your homeowner's insurance or renter's insurance. As far as the amount of time that may have passed, I believe you said it was in 2014. I'm going to defer to you, Vic, as far as whether or not that incarceration may have told the statute of limitations.
That's a good question. I'm going to get back to that, too. What I think you should know is generally there would be a 4-year statute of limitations on the damage to property, and that time is run. But there's generally a six-year statute of limitations on the claim for homeowners, which I thought was a great idea.
Yes, sir.
To pursue. Now, if the criminal prosecution was related to the trucking accident, there's some Georgia law that may cause the statute to be told, but it should be related to the incident which gave rise to your property damage. I would think, as a general rule.
Mm-hmm.